Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Bogey McSandtrap Career Mode series here in Rory McIlroy PGA Tour Golf on the Xbox One. We are about to tee off the third round of the Players Championship, and as we get ready here at TPC Sawgrass, here we go. Bogey, he had a little trouble on the 17th again for the second day in a row, among other holes here, but he does have a share of the lead. There are a lot of people at 9-under starting today. Holy cow, a lot of people at 9-under. I think I counted like six names there atop the leaderboard, so let's see how Bogey plays into this today in round three. That's his tee shot from the first hole. Digging that. Okay, so his second shot now on one. It's looking all right. Should get to the green. Looks like even on the side we want to be on there. Okay, should leave him by about 8-9 feet, I would guess. Just eyeballing it. Let's see what it is. 9 feet. Okay, and he makes that putt for birdie. So he's now 10 under. Sweet. Moving forward now. He's got that lead. Because everyone else is either... Well, no, there's guys on the course already. Rory has not teed off yet. Whoa, that one just slightly off there, you see on the swing, but it goes way to the right with that 7-mile-an-hour wind, and he's in the mulch. In the mulch. Not where we want to be, but at least there's no tree in his way, so he can get back on the fairway rather easily right there with a straight swing. Good deal. Okay. Shot number three coming up. Well, actually, we're going to skip that. We're to the green now, and his birdie putt, nope, not even close, from 31 feet. So he'll go for that par now and move on to the next hole. I'm going to line this up. Par putt. There we go. Okay. Remains at 10 under. Bogey with the orange hat, with the pink shirt and the gray vest. Yes. Bogey does dress in the dark some days, I'm beginning to believe. This is a par 3-3. Yeah, and that's looking pretty... Oh, it's short, though. No, it's going to roll onto the green. Okay, we're good. Actually, a really good roll. Really good roll right there. Going to leave him a decent, better than decent, birdie opportunity. 11 feet, up a couple inches. Yes, he gets it. Four birdie. 11 under now for Bogey McSandtrap. Look at that. Garcia and Mickelson are at 10. Putting the pressure on. Nice. He finds himself behind a tree here on his tee shot. Going through some more trees and past the gallery and somehow almost gets that onto the green. All things considered. Oh, he walks through a tree there. Be careful. All things considered, he's doing pretty good. Oh, somebody told me to stop saying all things considered. You said I sound like a public radio show or something. Maybe I should just go total divas with it and just be at the end of the day. I think there should be a drinking game on Total Divas every time they say at the end of the day. But that's another story. Bogey still at 11 under with the par. Fifth hole, second shot. The approach to the green. And right at the flag. Very nice. Take that anytime. 209 yards right under the green. Close approach. Bogey from, what is it, about 9 feet? Going to shorten that up just a little bit. And, oh, it just rolls past the hole. Oh, shoot. All right, well, according to you guys, I missed that on purpose. So believe what you want to believe. But here's the par putt, and he'll sink that. So par for that course on that hole, at least. And the bunnies are not amused. They don't seem to be really excited about what Bogey McSandtrap's doing, but that's okay. He's the leader, and he does not need the approval of those damn bunnies. So here we go on to hole number six. A little far there, but still in nice position. On the green. Actually, no, he's off the green. He's going to be chipping here for birdie. Oh, thought he's going to sink that. Not quite. All right. Let's try this again with the putter, shall we? 6 feet. Makes it for par. Moving along, continuing at that comfortable 11 under. Just waiting for one of these guys to press and join him there at 11 under. Hasn't happened yet, though. Let's see if we can put some more pressure on the par three. Maybe birdie this thing. Let's go. The tee shot is going to roll really close. Stop, stop, stop. Okay. Pretty close still. Let's see if he can get this putt for birdie. He needs it. 6 foot. Here's the putt. And yes, read that one right. Those are the tricky ones right there. I always feel like, am I going to give it too much, too little? I don't know. Some of you are like, oh, you make the 20-foot putts and not the 5-foot ones. Well, sometimes the 5-foot ones are harder depending on reading the green, you know? So that's going to catch a tree branch and then in the bunker. Not where he wanted to be on that. Obviously wanted to be in the middle of the fairway, but that's not to be. So the shot out of the sand trap for Mick Sandtrap, and now he's in the rough. Yeah, he's kind of scuffling along here, but it's a par 5, so he still has a very good chance to get par on this, and almost a birdie. Not quite. All right, so let's just try to par this thing and call it even here. Par putt. Yes, sinks it. Okay, nice save there. That'll keep him at 12 under, and look at the log jam at 10 under. McIlroy, Fowler, Kamer, Perez, all at 10 under. There might be more under that. I don't even know. But here is the 10th, the second shot. A little bit to the right of the pin, but very nice opportunity yet again at birdie. I gave him about a 50-50 chance here from, how far is this? 15 feet, 16 feet? No, 13 feet. He makes it. Doesn't matter how far away it was. He got it. Birdie putt, 13 under. Two shots up. Oh, there's Rory taking a shot off his game as well, too. He's 11 under to distance himself in second place there. So on the 11th, whoa, look out. Oh, it missed the tree somehow. Lucky there. That was not a straight shot at all. It is in the rough, however. Could have been much worse. This is much worse. It's in the water. It's short. Didn't play it long enough. Ouch. Okay. So that's a swan ball. They're going to go have fun finding that one, retrieving that. Meanwhile, Bogey beside himself wants to smash something with his club right now and said he's going to have to drop this and take a penalty and play it. So here's already his 5th shot. And he'll be on the green, but this is going to be a putt for Bogey. Man, okay. Not good. You would think it was the 17th or something the way he's playing this. He does make the bogey putt. Still not happy with himself. As he's visibly... Yeah, just getting mad there. He's one shot in the lead right now after dropping one. Look at these. Three guys there at 11 under. Putting the pressure on. That better not go in the water. Whoa. Okay. Nope. Made it to the green. Ooh, okay. Starting to get a little scared of the ball taking a drink at this point. Just definitely a priority to try to not get that to happen here. Birdie putt. Yes. Sinks it. Okay. Very nice recovery there after the bogey. Comes back and gets the birdie and has a 2-stroke lead over pretty much everybody here chasing him at 11 under. Man, oh man. They're staying right there. The 14th. That's off to the right. Way off to, whoa. That's not even a tree problem. That's a water problem. That's just rough. That's really bad right there. So he's going to have to play with a penalty shot. And look out, everybody. 4. Oh, my. Could have really hurt somebody badly. Instead, it hits a shrubbery there or something. Some kind of plant. Yikes. Okay, so he's playing this off the golf cart path, apparently. And he's looking at least a bogey on this one. Very mad over there. He's saying, I'm blowing a tournament over here. This isn't good. 4 bogey to just drop one shot. I mean, this would be a killer putt. Oh, can he get it? He's got it. Oh, so close. No. Almost got it for 37 feet, but no. He's like, what? No. Okay, no. Don't throw your putter in the pond or anything like that. You don't need to do that. It is a double bogey, though, and he's right back with the rest of the field. Actually, he's been passed up by Fowler and Kamer there. Yikes. They're at 12 under. Bogey's there with McIlroy and Herman. All right, 16th. You know what's coming up after the 16th, right? Yep, the 17th. It's got to be in his head right now. As that does not go in the sand trap, but it's in the rough. Just really having issues right now driving the fairway. Little chip too far. Stay on. Oh, my goodness. That almost just rolled right into the lake or into the pond, whatever. Kind of a messy end to this round right now. Almost chipped out for birdie. but it's going to be a par, and he's going to stay at 11 under, assuming he taps this in, which he does. So now we go to the 17th. Hold your breath, guys. It's the 17th. I think double bogeys first 2 days on this hole. You know he's just got to be thinking, okay, how do I play this? I've tried to play it short. Didn't work. I went off to the left last time, and this is short, but can it make it? Oh, so close. He almost got on. But again, it hits the edge of that, and then in the water, he can't believe it. He did it again. So now his third shot after the penalty. He's on right there. Oh, boy. 17th, he just wants to throw this hole out the window. So frustrating for him right now. This is for bogey. He misses the bogey putt. He misses the bogey putt. What? He's just absolutely ready just to go nuts right now. Like rip off all his clothes and just go jump in the lake or something. He's absolutely beside himself. He's now at 9 under, and look at this. Down to 6th on the leaderboard. Ouch. On 18 here. If he could hole out with this little pitch there, that'd be great. No, nope. Oh, wow. He's not even setting himself up for a good par putt. Disastrous end of this round. It just gets worse and worse and worse. And this is for par. And it's a long ways away. And it's not an easy read. But from 23 feet, he does get it. Okay. Well, he's psyched for that. He's got to hang on to anything he can get right now because he just fell apart on the back nine today. Just blew up. He's going to have to put that out of his head and just move on to this final round and try to play some lights out golf here because he's got some ground to catch up now. He's 9 under, and Fowler, the leader at 12 under, definitely going to have to come out here on fire in the fourth round if he wants to win the Players' Championship. They're mowing the 3D grass as I'm about to get out of here. We'll see you for the fourth round coming up next. Hoping for better luck on 17 especially. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!